The mini maze is a minimally invasive approach to cardiac tissue ablation used for atrial fibrillation. The operation is done making some small incisions in each armpit, opening the lining around the heart to do the burns on the heart tissue. After the operation, there'll be a drainage tube in each side, which usually come out in about 24 to 48 hours. Most patients have a moderate amount of pain and will have pain medication after surgery for the incisions, but I've had many patients back to fairly aggressive activity within 7 to 10 days. One of the advantages of the mini maze over other less invasive approaches, even such as catheter ablation, is the ability to remove the left atrial appendage where that clot forms, and also do a more complete lesion, more complete ablation to isolate the left atrial tissue, which is where these signals for atrial fibrillation come from. I think another advantage is the ability to get patients off of their antiarrhythmic medications that are sometimes quite expensive and have interactions with a lot of other medications. Patients with atrial fibrillation that are symptomatic probably benefit the most in terms of curing them of their symptoms and getting them off of their medications. Many of these patients are on long-term blood thinners that have their own known complications. And atrial fibrillation also leads to clot or thrombus in the heart, and that can break off and cause a stroke. One of the aspects of the mini maze is to remove a small section of the heart where the clot forms in patients with atrial fibrillation, thereby hopefully decreasing their stroke risk over their life. What I tell my patients is that if your symptoms that you are complaining of, the fatigue, shortness of breath, those things are a result of your atrial fibrillation, then curing your atrial fibrillation will help those. So if your symptoms are due to atrial fibrillation, which they are in the majority of patients, then it will, you know, drastically improve your symptoms. The other side is that there are many patients living with atrial fibrillation and they don't have very many symptoms. The reality is it doesn't change their risk of stroke because they aren't having symptoms. They can still form clot in their heart and still have a stroke. That doesn't take that risk away simply because they don't feel their palpitations or feel fatigued or short of breath. It's still a disease that puts them at great risk.
For more information about this physician or to schedule an appointment, please call our referral line or visit notbiggerjustbetterhealth.com.